start our game, we can pick a right or left flipper button.
Detroit Rocks. Pinball and music, and rock and roll music in particular, it's a great marriage because when you're younger and become interested in music and it starts affecting your life, you're usually listening to music that is not the music of your mom and dad. It is that music of the next generation, that new group, that new thing, that new sound that's out there. You became an adult and you acquired some different tastes. You still have that music vibe in your head. It's in your personality. It's in your bones. You walk up to a pinball machine that has Kiss music. You are hearing music that's drawing back experiences that you had when you were in junior high, in high school, and in college. And so before you even flipped one ball, you're like, this game is awesome.
My name is John Borg, and I'm a game designer at Stern Pinball, currently working on the Kiss project. It's an all-out, no-expense-spared rock and roll show.
Kiss is a perfect pinball machine because they are the epitome of rock icons.
The best theme in the world for pinball.
Their shows are huge and flashy and spectacular, so that translates really well to pinball.
Awesome characters, awesome effects.
Kiss is not one of those bands that's been around a long time. Everybody knows who they are, whether you like them or not. You have to respect what they've done all these years since we're talking 40 years of music.
Kiss. Who doesn't like Kiss?
Great theatrics, great stage presence, and they spit blood.
They were superheroes. They have a place in my childhood memories of just epic proportions.
There's already been a Kiss pinball machine, and it was a successful pinball machine. It'd be nice to bring it up to the next century, do a Kiss pinball right.
Today, we've got better resources and better technology.
Obviously, there's been a Kiss pinball game before, and that's a little bit of what we're looking at, is making kind of a throwback to that game. Very much paying homage, but at the same time, we want something modern.
Bally produced a Kiss pinball machine in 1979. Kevin O'Connor did all the artwork for that project. When we decided we were going to do Kiss a second time, I talked to Kevin, and he was like, Kiss all awesome, you know, I'm ready. Kevin is going to be the artist on the game, and he's hand-drawing everything, and it's just looking fantastic.
The Kiss pinball machine was one of the coolest pinball machines I'd ever seen. The art on that ultimate artifact from the 70s. But the machine itself, like, it's not my favorite playing machine. Having the opportunity to take that game and do another version that has everything we've learned about pinball, add rules and toys and things to make it the ultimate game, it's a great opportunity and challenge, and we're going to kick its ass.
Got a whole bunch of people.
I'm working with Elliot, Mike Redoble, Rob Blakeman, and Lonnie Rapp, our programming.
Hi, I'm Lonnie Rapp.
We are just cranking away right now.
I've worked with John on many titles in the past. We had an opportunity to work on Guns N' Roses and many games since then.
The vibe's really good on the team.
Tanya Kleiss.
We got me. I'm working on the team. I'm doing a lot of system programming and some cool music, synced light programming.
He is our Kiss expert, has really been influenced by them.
I'm a big Kiss fan, yeah.
All of the nuances and the little subtle things, he is the one who's helping identify those and making sure that they get put into the game.
We've got a new person, Chuck Ernst, who is leading the animation.
I've been in the game industry for like 20 some years, and I can tell you, hands down, I've never met bigger fanatics about pinball and also the license. It's funny pulling into the parking lot and listening to these guys cranking Kiss. They're like, yeah, you know, Kiss. I'm super stoked about it too. It's a great team to work with.
We got this rock band called Kiss. He's providing music and doing custom voiceover.
Gene and Paul are both going to record speech for the game.
The Demon and the Star Child.
We wrote probably 600 lines.
I want to say 45 pages.
We have 10 songs that are going to be featured on the game.
10 awesome Kiss songs.
Had they picked half a dozen other songs than the ones that we'll be using in the game, it would have been fine because it's all good.
My favorite Kiss song, it's difficult to choose between Detroit Rock City and Deuce.
God of Thunder.
A lot of guys are like, you know, shout it out loud, they go for the hard rock and kind of stuff. I'm more of a Beth fan. There's a soft Kiss side that I think is in all of us.
But if I'm driving and I don't need to worry about getting stopped by the cops, then Detroit Rock City is a really good driving song.
You can pick the music.
You get to pick the songs right when you start the game.
If you play Paul Stanley's little stage area, you get Love Gun. Gene's Head, Dr. Love.
So there'll be some features in the game that will use certain songs, but some of those songs you can actually pick at the beginning as far as you want.
This machine is going to be an experience. We're going to make our Kiss Rock concert, and we're going to put that in a pinball machine. You need music, which we got. You need lights. We're going to have lights, and we're going to have, like, You got Gene Simmons' head.
Large molded Gene head, which is sitting right next to me here.
The most awesome feature of the game, Gene Simmons' big head on the playfield.
That's going to be something that's very interactive.
You can see we have a mock-up here, a giant Gene Simmons head that spits balls. You can't go wrong with that.
There's a shot underneath Gene, so when you shoot the ball under Gene's head, it goes under him and it kind of disappears for a couple seconds, and then it kind of comes out like a pitching machine and it shoots the ball right, left. You never know where it's going. There's a trough that goes up into the back of Gene's head where you can store three balls.
Gonna get a chance to see something shooting off this giant tongue.
There's another one that's gonna be featured in the LE game that's specifically for Paul. You shoot a ball through a ramp.
The right ramp is also gonna have a shot that goes to the back panel. It's got this big diverter that will divert the ball around. When the shot is lit, it'll go down and then hit the back panel. And then there's this mech, that mic design, which slides the ball over and it's gonna drop it off. It was kind of challenging because of this interface here. We had to have something that went up, diverted the ball, and then fall down so the ball wouldn't get stuck.
There's a diverter here where the slot is. Normally the ball's gonna pass around the radius of the ramp and feed into the wire and come back to your flipper. But when it's time, this diverter will drop down and the ball's gonna go up the ramp to the back panel and it's gonna stick to the back panel. And then the ball's gonna come out and it's gonna walk across the back panel and it's gonna fall off and it's gonna roll down into Paul's special play area.
This is the floating ball. What we have here is basically a magnetized ball on a pulley system. We have a DC motor here on a XL 0.2 pitch pulley, basically being slowly brought across.
Similar to what Paul does at concert, cable with a ring comes to him, it picks him up and it carries him over the crowd. So I wanted to kind of recreate that in pinball.
That's something that hasn't been done in a long time on a pinball machine. That's kind of a retro thing with a little bit of a modern take. Pinball nuts will really dig it. One of the things I'm doing right now is kind of prototyping some of the gameplay features. So if you look in here, the ball goes up the ramp, hits the magnetic pickup in the back, gets picked up, does its thing, gets dropped off on a ramp, drops back into gameplay, and then that starts a multi-ball sequence. Now this is just early masked out stuff for the low screen, but this will be Star Child asking people, taunting them, going, do you want me to come out there? And that's when he does his skywalk.
The coolest, biggest feature in the game may not be the obvious. There are mechanical features on the game that will interact with the ball, but the coolest feature on the game is the music. The music is so integrated.
The rock and roll, I guess, is the greatest feature of this game.
The initial feel of the game is being able to put the player in a concert.
So when you're in a concert, you have all of those sights and sounds, but we wanted to also bring out the personality of Gene and Paul.
For this game, we are still using the DMD display, but we are using all digitized footage. No hand art stuff. It'll have actual concert footage.
Right now, I'm working on generic crowd audience, possibly background for a mode.
This is Starman's rocket. He likes to shoot rockets off of his guitar occasionally. The red background kind of works like a green screen, so that when the programmers use this on the actual marquee, they can just place it wherever they want, and it won't affect anything behind it. So he just fires off a rocket and goes back to his resting pose. I can turn Demon on if I want. So now it's Demon shooting off the rocket. Everything has to be like real exaggerated so that it shows up. The shoes here, thought they might be too small. If it were reality, they're probably a good like 10 inches tall. Also his spikes, 10 times bigger than they are. It's been fun seeing it come together like this.
This is where you get a match at the end of the game. Usually the match involves revealing a number. If the number matches the last two digits on your score, you get a free game. The fire reveals the number and the number shows up like right there. Gene Simmons does this fire breathing thing and we had to figure out some way to get it in there. I mean, that's iconic. So this is actually a CG model. This is a video footage of him. We actually modeled him in 3D and then animated him and then deposited in some fire. We have a full Gene Simmons and then he has a face rig. Eyelids. He's got like eyebrows. He's got full function left, right.
A lot of people collect Kiss memorabilia, and I think this is just going to be the one toy that you're just going to have. The pinball community, they're just going to love the way the game shoots. There's a lot of flow in the game. There's a lot of toys on it. There's a spinning disc underneath Gene's head that just chucks the ball back out at you like a pitching machine. There's a scoop in the game where you can start wizard mode. There's a lot of targets in the game. Paul is in the game as a stand-up figure. He's standing next to a little amplifier, and he actually moves back and forth, and he dances to the music. There's just a lot for everybody.
We try to draw elements in the previous game, not just art elements, but also mechanical elements. So those pop bumper caps that you see, those drop targets that you see, the band members, the grid of inserts at the bottom. We're basically taking a game that people love from yesteryear, and we are supersizing and making it a modern day cool rock and roll theme. It is like going to a concert.
I think it's just gonna be a thing of beauty, and everybody's gonna have to have one.
What a rock and roll all night, and party every day. question is, who do I associate with most?
I would be the Demon. My personality fits his, and his boots just rock.
Well, I would have to be Star Child. Hanging from cords and you know, flying around the stage. I don't think I could do the whole puking up blood.
Probably primarily, most of the time, I relate to the spaceman the most. The fact that he is from outer space is pretty cool. I think I could relate to that.
I'm probably the techie guy that's in the back running the boards for all the pyrotechnics that are happening at a concert.
Soundwave. I think when the Kiss band approached the aliens, Gene would walk up and start shaking his head and blood would start spilling out of his mouth.
I think it's going to be a real team effort.
The Demon, the Star Child, they're just going to do everything.
They're obviously going to lead the charge with their superpowers.
I think they just have to play loud enough and they'll want to leave.
They'll stomp on them with their big platform shoes.
Having them like kind of the mecha Gene Simmons flying around, being able to spit fire out.
Or just scaring them away.
I mean, we're going to need some government funding probably to help enhance their powers, but
I don't know how they'd save it. Probably Earth is gonna be destroyed.
Stern's next lineup is